Hi, welcome back to my channel. I'm Farah, and in today's video, we're going to talk about a few different job families in cybersecurity and how you can get started with them. But before we get into this video, let me talk about today's sponsors, BUGCROWD. BUGCROWD is a bug bounty platform, and they have tons of programs for you to choose from and start your bug bounty journey. They also have their own YouTube channel where they have guest lectures from some really talented hackers, and I'm going to link their channel down so that you can subscribe and check the content out. And if you want to start hunting and start your bug bounty journey, then use this link to sign up on BUGCROWD. And if you're interested in knowing about the job families in cybersecurity, then please continue watching. So if you want to enter cybersecurity, then you should know that you have the option to take your career in a few different directions. And this obviously depends upon your skill, your interest, your goals, and the opportunities available around you. In this video, we're going to talk about a few of those job families. Since we're only going to cover a few of them, let me know if you like this kind of a video, and I can definitely make a part two. The first job family that we're going to talk about is security architecture. The day-to-day job of a security architect involves building and designing a securely designed system for an organization. If you enjoy building, planning, and designing, then this might be a good fit for you because this is more like a big picture approach to cybersecurity. Some skills that you can learn and are good to know for this field are critical thinking, knowledge of IT systems administration and networking, and some knowledge of risk assessment as well. And some certifications that can help you out with this are CompTIA Security Plus and CISSP. The next job family that we're going to talk about is incident response. The day-to-day job of an incident responder involves analyzing and monitoring the network and system of an organization to fix any kind of vulnerabilities that may arise or notice any kind of unusual behavior. More importantly, incident responders are the ones who take action whenever a security breach happens or is attempted against an organization, and they are the ones who try to minimize any kind of loss from that breach. Some skills that you can learn and are good to have for incident response is familiarity with intrusion detection tools and different kinds of forensic software, as well as being good at technical writing for documentation. Some certifications that can help you out with these skills are GCIH and CCE. Pen testing, red teaming, ethical hacking. This job family has different names depending upon the exact job role. But to avoid confusion here, we'll just call it pen testing. The day-to-day job of a pen tester involves testing an organization's assets and finding security vulnerabilities. Then they report those security vulnerabilities to the organization so that it can be fixed before an attacker comes to exploit it. You can also do this independently by doing bug bounties on a platform like BUGCROWD, where you can get paid to legally hack an organization's assets. And some skills that you can learn for pen testing are scripting, networking, and understanding how an application works. Some certifications that can help you out with these skills are OSCP and EJPP. Lastly, for this video, we have digital forensics. The day-to-day job involves retrieving information from devices, analyzing that data to understand if any unauthorized person had accessed the system, documenting this whole process, working with the law for any cybercrime-related investigations, and some digital forensic experts even provide testimony in court proceedings. A certification for digital forensics is GCFE, which can help you out with the needed skills. So that's all I had for you in this video. Cybersecurity is a constantly growing field, and the job families are also growing with that. And some job fields like DevSecOps did not make it in this video, but if you like this kind of a video, then let me know and I can cover it in a part two. That's all I had for you in this video. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you learned something new from this. Bye!